Removing the vocals from a song is like taking a baked cake and reverting it into its original ingredients. That's insane. And I'm gonna teach you how to do that with any song on your Mac. So whether you want to create a karaoke version of your favorite song or your own custom remix, then this is the class for you. That's coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hey folks, and welcome to the class. I have to tell you folks, I've seen technology do some pretty crazy stuff over the years, but this one even blows my mind. To separate the audio of any song on your Mac, you're going to need two apps. Now, one of them does require some very minor custom configuration when you're initially installing it, but hey, don't worry folks, that's why you got me, and I'll walk you through that process in just a moment. The first app that you're gonna need is GarageBand.
Excellent!
That's that app that came with your Mac, but you probably never used it or maybe even deleted it to free up space. And hey, if you did, that's okay. You can always re-download it from the App Store on your Mac. The other app that you're gonna need is called My Spleeter. Now, personally, I think My Spleeter sounds like something you pull when trying to pretend that you're an outdoorsy person when, let's face it, you're not an outdoorsy person. But I digress. My Spleeter is the Mac version of Spleeter, which is made by the audio company Deezer. To download My Spleeter, you will find a link to their website in the video description. From there, you need to click the link listed here under Download. Depending on what operating system you are running, you may need to change one security setting in order to be able to install it. So let me take a quick moment to walk you through that process. When you download My Spleeter, you'll find the DMG file here in your Downloads folder. When you double-click on it, you'll now have to drag this icon into the Applications folder. At this point, I'll just press Command-N on my keyboard to open a new Finder window, and I'll drag and drop My Spleeter here into the Applications folder. When you go to double-click on My Spleeter, you may encounter a warning screen about installing apps from unknown developers. To allow it to install anyways, let's go to the Apple icon at the top left and click on System Preferences. Now, let's navigate to Security and Privacy and make sure that you're here on the General tab. To make changes, I'll need to authenticate by clicking the lock icon and entering the password to my user account. Now just click Open anyways, and you'll probably get one more pop-up, and all you need to do is click Open. So now if we double-click on My Spleeter, it should open, and as you can see here, it's pretty straightforward. Just drag the song that you want to separate into Input, then tell it where you want to save the new files. For convenience, I'll save it to my desktop. Now just click Separate. And depending on how fast your computer is, this process can take anywhere from several seconds to a minute or two. And just a heads up, you may get that spinning rainbow pinwheel during this process, but just wait it out. So after about 30 seconds or so, My Spleeter has created a folder on my desktop. If we open it up, you'll see it has separated everything into five tracks: bass, drums, other, which includes things like synthesizers, piano, and vocals. At this point, let's fire up GarageBand and create a brand new empty project. On this next screen, let's select the microphone icon. Now I'm gonna bring up my Finder window, highlight these files, and drag and drop all of them into my project. Just be sure when you go to do this that you drag them towards the beginning of the track. If you're not familiar with GarageBand, this icon right here will mute any track. So let's start by muting every track except for the drums, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slowly add the other tracks back in just so that you can get the full effect. The song that I'm gonna use for this demonstration is one that always gets me going at the gym. That would be Cold Heart by Dua Lipa and Elton John. Now, for copyright reasons, I have to be really careful about how long I play this song during this presentation, so just know when we get to the part where you hear the whole song, it's gonna be really, really short because you don't wanna piss off Elton John. Right? Now, look, this software is not perfect, but I think you will agree that it absolutely qualifies as buckets of fun. So now that you know how to use it, I want you to do me a favor and let me know in the comments section what is the first song that you are going to use with this software. And also, how are you going to use it? And if alcohol is going to be involved, then you absolutely need to buy me a drink. Venmo, PayPal, it's all good. Bags of cash, gold. Hey, one last thing before we go. I want to give you something to think over. I want you to think about your relationship with the technology in your life. Okay, think about it like it were an actual relationship. Would you think of it like a positive relationship, like Lucy and Ricky? Well, on camera, not necessarily off camera. Or would it be maybe more of a challenging relationship? Like, oh, I don't know. One of the things that I've done over the last 10 years when I'm not making video content here on YouTube is I do a lot of private tech lessons with people. And I've actually lately come to refer to it as tech therapy. You know, we all have our little problems with technology and we need someone who can be there to help resolve those problems and help offer solutions. And I love being able to do that with people. If you'd like to sign up for a little tech therapy session with David, go ahead and visit my website at techtalkamerica.com/private lessons. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.